Good evening, and welcome to Wednesday Night Wellness Live. I'm Dr. Andrew Merrill here at Nightlight Chiropractic, and this is the video that we do each and every week to bring you, the viewer, the most common complaints that we're seeing and what we can do about it, right? Like, I'm always looking for ideas for you to keep you healthy, to keep you well, to keep you out of my office, to keep you at the top of your game here, especially at the end of 2020. Here we are in the middle of holiday season, and we're getting a lot of weird new cases in, right? I mean, we're getting all kinds of things coming to the office right now. And one of the things that we're getting right now coming into the office is patients saying that they're having some elbow pain while they are doing their Christmas wrapping. Have you started your Christmas wrapping? This is live, so I'd love to hear from you. If you've started your Christmas wrapping, give me a yep or a yes or a yeah, still wrapping, haven't started, haven't thought about it. We're in the thick of things here, and I was just doing some wrapping here the other morning, and I started to have some of this elbow pain too. And the reason why, I think, is from these things, right? From your scissors. So as you're going about cutting up that wrapping paper, you're using a bunch of hand and wrist muscles. And if you're getting elbow pain when you're doing that, I know what it is, and I'm gonna show you how to fix it here this evening without ever stepping foot in any medical office, including mine. So first of all, really important, this, what you're getting when you're getting pain along the outside part of your elbow when you're using scissors or doing some other kind of manual work, is almost inevitably tennis elbow, right? And it's weird because that's actually otherwise known as lateral epicondylitis, but when people think tennis elbow, they think, well, I don't play tennis, how could I possibly be having tennis elbow? But when you're getting tennis elbow or that lateral epicondylitis from using scissors to cut your wrapping paper, what it's coming from is anytime you use your hands and do flexion extension of your fingers and or wrist, you're using all of these muscles here, right? You see these muscles kind of flopping around, and all of those muscles join together here at the lateral epicondyle of the humerus by this common tendon, right? Called the extensor carpi radialis brevis tendon. And what it does is it links all of these muscles to one particular point in your elbow, right? And it's really important to understand that when we're getting that elbow pain from using scissors or from a variety of other manual tasks, what's happening is that we're creating inflammation and then eventually tearing in that ECRB tendon, that extensor carpi radialis brevis. All that means is that it's the tendon that kind of helps you to extend your wrist and some of your digits, right? And eventually that inflammation will cause a little bit of gap, a little bit of tearing in those collagen fibers, and then you actually have a hole. You have a hole in the tendon as it attaches to that lateral epicondyle, that bony prominence there, and all of those join right there. So if you're having some pain right on the outside of your elbow while you're using those scissors to cut your wrapping paper, that's what it is. So what are we gonna do about this? How are we gonna fix this? Well, first we have to stop the offending motion, right? So we all know that little trick about gliding the scissors up that paper, right? You find that sweet spot and you glide those scissors right up there as opposed to chomp, chomp, chomping along. So that's a good fix, right? But also making sure that you're changing up how your wrist sits while you're doing that motion, maybe pacing yourself a little bit, right? Don't do what I did and do, you know, 3 or 4 hours of wrapping all in one sitting. You wanna make sure that you're spacing this out as best you can, and maybe that means you need to start now to get it all done in time. But first and foremost, if you're getting that elbow pain while you're doing that motion, you need to stop doing that motion, right? So stopping that offending motion is going to make sure that we are limiting how much inflammation, swelling, and tearing happens at that area. And that's important because even just a few minutes of doing that manual motion can lead to weeks of pain, right? It can lead to a lot more pain. So you wanna pace yourself just a little bit while you're going through some of that motion that you're doing. All right, so second, we need to reduce the swelling and inflammation. How are we gonna reduce that swelling and inflammation? Well, one of the best things that we can do is ice, right? And it's a little bit harder to ice this area, like to just throw a bag of ice. I guess you could throw just a bag of ice on there. But one of the other ways you can do it is to freeze a cup of water, right? So I've frozen a cup of water here in a styrofoam cup. It's not ideal. A paper cup is actually better, but you can't really find paper cups much anymore. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna peel away some of the outer covering of that. And now I've got this nice little shell here, right? And I can use that shell to massage that area. And as I massage that area, I'm giving a little bit of friction to the area, which is good, a little cross friction massage to the area, but also I'm reducing the amount of swelling in the area, right? So an ice cup comes in really handy if you have done too much cutting, too much wrapping. You can ice down that area afterwards with that frozen cup of ice that you have there. The second thing that we can do, actually, I need to make mention of this because this was brought up by another one of my patients. They read about using contrasting hot and cold. And this is actually one of those things that in the literature actually responds really well to contrasting hot and cold. So you can use a little bit of heat on there, then ice, then heat, then ice. Just make sure that you're ending on ice to reduce that swelling, okay? So what else can we do? We are going to use a tennis elbow strap, right? So if you've never seen one of these things, you can buy these things at Walgreens, Walmart, Target, a lot of other places have them. Here's how we're gonna use it though. You're gonna go one finger's breadth below where you're having all that pain. So where you're having all that pain is actually the lateral epicondyle. You wanna go one finger's breadth below that, and then you wanna use this strap very snugly with this little blue spot or this little cushion pad right over those muscles there. Right? And then you're gonna use that snugly all waking hours for about a week and a half to 2 weeks, right? Don't sleep in this thing, but anytime you're up and about, you wanna have this thing on. And the rationale for that is that a lot of times you're using your hands and you don't even realize you're using your hands for a variety of things. From typing to 100 other things, you're using your hands. If you don't have this thing on, you're probably missing a little bit about the things that you're doing, right? So you wanna have this tennis elbow brace on the entire time you're doing it. So what else can we do? Well, we want to, we want to take some of the load off of that ECRB tendon, right? So we want to eventually strengthen some of the other muscles in the area. And to do that, we're going to use another common household item. It's a rubber band, right? And I got four different versions of a rubber band right here. This is actually a hair tie, I suppose, but all of these are all you need to strengthen some of those other muscles. And here's how we're gonna use those, right? We're gonna do combinations of your thumb and your fingers to do extension, right? So you're gonna do just like this. You're doing extension, you're bringing your middle finger up again and again and again, and then you're gonna do it with your pointer finger, right? Your first finger, and you go up and down. And you're gonna do it with your ring finger and go up and down. You're gonna do it with your pinky and go up and down. Very, very easy homework to do with nothing but a rubber band. You don't wanna do this while you're inflamed, right? So if you just got done cutting your wrapping paper or doing a 3 or 4 hour stint wrapping paper, you don't wanna jump straight to this rubber band. You wanna use that ice cup. You wanna reduce some of the inflammation. You wanna start wearing your tennis elbow brace maybe. This rubber band trick is for down the road, maybe a week or two after some of that swelling and inflammation goes down. Or if you recurrently get, if you chronically get this tennis elbow, you wanna make sure that you're doing the strengthening exercise. So we're gonna do that extension exercise with all of our different fingers, right? We're gonna do 10 reps with each finger. And then we wanna do a side-to-side motion as well, right? So we wanna do a side-to-side motion for all of our fingers. And if the rubber band is a little bit too loose, you can double it over so that you get a little bit of extra tension, right? And that extra tension is gonna help to get you a little better workout on your fingers, I suppose. So you wanna do that side-to-side motion between all of your fingers as well. So once we do all those different exercises, one set of 10 each is plenty. We're gonna stop doing it, we're gonna skip another day, and then we're gonna get back to it the following day. So that's it, that's all I have for this evening. But if you're getting that tennis elbow, if you know somebody who's getting that tennis elbow, specifically from wrapping presents, now is the time, this is the time of year to send them towards this video. And get some secrets so that they can avoid a costly visit to the doctor for no reason. Let's see, so I got a question here. Is it okay to take Motrin or aspirin before you start the wrapping? It is actually, and the research is pretty clear on this one too, that NSAIDs, non-steroidal anti-inflammatories like Motrin and aspirin, can help to reduce some of the swelling. So you can take that before you start going. Just understand that even though you're not necessarily feeling some of the pain while you're doing that, you are still creating some of the inflammation and swelling and tearing to those collagen fibers that could come back to get you later on down the road. So even though you take the ibuprofen or the aspirin before you start, you need to be careful, because if you're still getting that pain while you're using the scissors to do all the wrapping, you're gonna end up having that tennis elbow, not while you're doing it, but a day or two after you do it. And that's when you need to go back to your icing instructions, to using your elbow wrap, and then eventually down the line using that rubber band. So NSAID's good, but not necessarily a catch-all. Anyways, that's all I have for this evening. I hope to see you again next Wednesday for one more of these before the end of the year. I hope you're in the middle of a fantastic holiday season, wrapping some presents, doing some gifts, spending some quality time with your family. Nobody's really traveling, but you make the most of it. You do the best that you can. I will see you next week for another Wednesday Night Wellness Live. If you know of anybody who would like to come talk with me on my show, who you think would be a good fit, send them my way, drmerrill@nightlightchiropractic.com. Also, you can find all kinds of great information on our website, our blog, our YouTube channel, and right here on Facebook Live. Anyways, have a great night. I'll see you next week for another Wednesday Night Wellness Live. Be well.